We have to address the problem at its root. Why are we really suffering? What is the cause? Oh, we are born in this world. And once we are born, everything else starts.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna.
It is not a fact that, as they say, Manav Seva is Madhav Seva. It's not a fact. Madhav Seva is Seva for not only Manav, but also the Jantu, and also the Devata, everybody. Because Yatha Taror Moola Nishechanena Tripyanti Tatskandha Bujopashakha Pranopahara Chayatendriyanam. See, Tathaiva Sarvar Hanamachutejya. So this verse 4.31.14, it is said, as pouring water on the root of a tree energizes the trunk, branches, twigs and everything else, and as supplying food to the stomach, enlivens the senses and limbs of the body, simply worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead through devotional service automatically satisfies the demigods who are parts of that Supreme Personality. And not only demigods, everybody. Sarva Arhanam. Sarva means all. Not only demigods, even everybody. That is the proper way to water a tree, to water its root. Then automatically all the branches, leaves, flowers, fruits, everything will get energized. But if you water a leaf, that is not called watering the tree. So similarly, leaf, just one part of Krishna's existence is humans. Just by serving them, you're not serving Krishna. And Prabhupada, there was one conversation where one person came to him and said, but Manav Seva is Madhav Seva, what is your thought? So Prabhupada said, then if that is the case, if Manav Seva is Madhav Seva, then Madhav Seva is Manav Seva, right? If A is equal to B, B is equal to A. So if Manav Seva is Madhav Seva, then Madhav Seva is Manav Seva. Then our process is superior because by just serving Madhav, we are serving all Manav. But for you to do Madhav Seva, you have to serve all Manav, then only you can serve Madhav. So you have to serve, how many Manav are there? Maybe 7 billion in population, 7.7 billion, I don't know what is the population now. All of them you serve and then your service to Madhav is complete. Whereas we are serving Madhav nicely and automatically Manav is being satisfied. Just by glorifying Krishna, sharing his message, all the people who hear are glorified. Just by offering him food and distribution, all the Manav are spiritually and materially satisfied. Materially their stomachs are satisfied, but spiritually also they are satisfied because they are eating the prasadam of Krishna. Without even them knowing, they are committing pious activities, they are going closer to Krishna. So this is Agyata Sukriti. Without even knowing they are committing pious activities. So in this way, they are being introduced to the Krishna consciousness. So that will ultimately save them from all problems. Because their real problem is lack of Krishna consciousness. Now they think their problem is, oh, I don't have enough money, I don't have enough food, oh, I don't have a life partner, or I don't have a business partner, or I don't have a business, or I don't have, I'm not enjoying my job. People think these are the actual problems of life. But no, these are symptoms of the real problem. The real problem is we are here in this material world because we have neglected Krishna. And because of that, we have to struggle in so many ways. If we solve one problem, there will be another problem. If we solve that problem, there will be another 10 problems. So in this way, it is only just increasing. To go faster, they thought going slow is so bad, we have to go fast. So for that, they have to build automobiles and it is very expensive, and to buy those automobiles, they have to, people work hard, and then they have to build roads for that, the infrastructure, the petrol, they have to drill the oceans, and that is a big endeavor in itself. And sometimes there is, you know, oil spill and so much natural devastation happens. And also, after even if everything goes alright, there is so much pollution in the air. So, to solve one problem, they are creating hundreds of problems. And they are trying to solve then hundreds of problems. And in that process, they are creating thousands of problems. And then they are trying to solve thousands of problems, creating millions of problems. This is how materialistic civilization is going on. So, if we try to combat the material problem with a material solution, we will end up in hundreds of more problems. And just our whole civilization is just wasted trying to counteract these problems only. This is called struggle for existence. Whereas, we have to address the problem at its root. Why are we really suffering? What is the cause? Oh, we are born in this world. And once we are born, everything else starts. Birth, after birth, disease, old age, death. And between that, there is tapatraya, adhyatmik, adhibhautik, adhidaivik miseries. So, it just goes on and on. So, the thing is birth. So, how to stop birth? Not by contraception. That's not the solution at all. That is even more sinful. The thing is that we are taking birth again and again and again. Contraception means what? The soul which was supposed to come, okay, it is not coming. Now he will go to another body somewhere else to find shelter. It is not that we are stopping. No, he's going to take birth anyway. No, but the thing is now we are going to punarapi jananam punarapi maranam. पुनरापि जननी जठरे शयनम इह संसारे बहुदुस्तारे कृपया पारे पाहि मुरारे. शंकराचार्य इज सेइंग दिस. भगवद्गीता ऑल्सो सेज जातस्य हि ध्रुवो मृत्युर् ध्रुवम जन्म मृतस्य च. सो एज वी टेक बर्थ डेथ इज सर्टन. सो सिमिलरली फॉर द पर्सन हु डाइड बर्थ इज सर्टन. इट इज जस्ट अ नेचुरल कॉन्सिक्वेंस. इट्स अ नेचुरल सीक्वेंस. सॉरी. So now we have to stop that. Now that this body has taken birth, it has to die. But after this death, we should not take birth again. Then automatically every other problem is solved. Suppose in my dream, if I am sleeping and I'm having so many problems in my dream. Somebody is attacking, or maybe I'm hungry, and then at the same time, you know, I mean, so many things are happening. Just imagine. So how to solve all these problems in the dream? The best way is to wake up. And that's what we should do. We should wake up spiritually. We are in this dreaming slumber state where we are dreaming. All this, what we are experiencing in this world is a dream. We have to wake up. That is the real solution for the whole thing. Suppose somebody is shouting, oh, tiger, tiger, tiger is attacking me, tiger is attacking me. You know, in the dream, if he shouts, then the person who is the friend, you know, sitting beside him, oh, what? What tiger? Tiger is attacking me, save me, save me. Then what he does? He tries to go into the dream and fight the tiger. No. He just, you know, pushes me, hey, wake up, wake up. What are you doing? Then he wakes up and, oh, okay, there's no tiger. So that's what is real help. The problem, the root of the problem is that he is hallucinating. The tiger is not the problem and nothing is the problem. His hallucination is the problem. Similarly, our hallucination, we are thinking that this is reality and trying to solve this by various other so-called solutions. No, it will not help. Our modern civilization is built like this, but it will not help. So we have to water the root of the tree, and that is Krishna.
Hare Krishna.